Today we will give a review on the Hollywood animated movie Street Gang. Sesame Street is one of the most popular and influential television show of all time. That's not an opinion, it's an objective fact. You don't stick around for over 50 years and win the hearts of countless children and parents. If you are not popular and influential, and yet Merlin Agello documentary Street Gang, How We Got Sesame Street now really tells us more than we already know. There are fun anecdotes, and it's nice to make sure audiences know the name of the people who created this hallowed piece of children educational entertainment. But Agello really seeks to dig deeper or to explore the show legacy beyond the audience's general awareness. I spent almost 2 hours with Street Gang, and while I am glad I know that creative forces involved and that Frank Oz and Jim Henson had fun playing Brad and Ernie together, my larger understanding of Sesame Street remains the same. The documentary kind of breezes throughout the genesis of Sesame Street and how John Gans Cooney brought in director John Stone, who then brought in Jim Henson to formulate a program that could use entertainment techniques for educational purposes. The argument is that if kids are already spending indiscriminate amounts of time in front of the television being sold products by mindless entertainment, then there should be a program that uses television for good but can still be entertaining. Furthermore, the show should be set in an inner city because it's trying to reach inner city kids who were falling behind their classmates in school. Further, the documentary relies in the show's growing popularity and cobbles together anecdotes like the origins of It's Not Easy Being Green, or how the show addresses the death of Mr. Hooper. Maybe I'm being a grudge, but I like feel if you are going to make 2 hour documentary about Sesame Street, it should be more than Isn't Sesame Street Wonderful. We all know it's wonderful, and to do nothing more than that tells me that you are not trying to provide insight into the show. As much as you are making commercial for something an audience has already purchased, there are not any dissenting voices against Sesame Street, like pointing out how a show that was created with federal funds became a marketing behemoth. Watching Street Gangs, you wouldn't even know the show existed past 1983 because there's no reckoning with how it has growing change and being purchased by HBO, the studio behind this documentary. I get the Sesame Street isn't for adults, but it's brazier that documentary about the show would treat its adult viewer like children's. Ultimately, that's what Street Gang is, a branding exercise. It means to celebrate Sesame Street and make you feel good about a show you already love. Furthermore, to treat Sesame Street with the kid gloves does a derisive to the show legacy. Sesame Street is an institution, and pointing out any missteps or controversies isn't going to tear down the series or what it means to people. Sesame Street was designed to educate instead of sell, but Street Gang feels designed to sell rather than educated. Dear viewers, I hope you like our videos. Please give us a review and give us your valuable feedback in comments below. Let us know how you like our videos. Then we will more informative videos for you. Our goal to introduce you to every Hollywood movie and English TV series. Thanks for watching.